Okay, so we left off. We're a little injured. Who cares? Let's go beat up ghosts. I don't think I actually touched anything here. Aha! I really like the sword attack setup here. It's really satisfying. Okay. Let me think. So these guys are all axe based, right? Yes. Good. That's the wrong enemy. Or is it? Never mind. Not the wrong enemy. Ha! Okay. It's been a couple of days since I played this. I was, it's the weekend, so I, of course, do all of my, like, collaborative stuff with people. Which is a lot of fun, of course, but, it does mean that I don't get the chance to stop moving so I can see what you're weak to. Alright, well, he's resistant to spears, so we'll have to hit him with fire. At least we do damage. They're weak to air, aren't they? Well, that'll get me combo. Let's just finish this guy off. It'll probably get us the overkill, so this guy doesn't get resistance to lightning? Hey, that is how it works. Nice. Okay. I like the weird session mechanics in this game just really, really do make the, like, turn-based battling way more interesting. I think I still prefer, like, Final Fantasy X-2's, style of combat, as weird as that probably sounds. X-2 was a lot of things, but it was actually rather fun. The combat was pretty good. I enjoyed having kind of an auto-battle system where I just select, like, extra skills on top of, you know, just the regular attacks. That was a nice setup in the game, and I really enjoyed that. And the... what? What? Huh? Hey, I'm busy. Can't you see that? Jeez, quit bothering me and scram. What's this about my performa? Is it that amazing? I've been attracting nothing but losers, it seems. Oh, so this is somebody else's character, I guess, for the time being. So we'll have to come back later when I have somebody, presumably. And let's see, treasure key. Oh, might as well use it. Hopefully we can get more. Bracelet of Eternity, that sounds cool. Okay, let's see, wardrobe. Might as well give it for her, I guess. Does the Bracelet of Eternity show up? Oh, yeah, I got a spare power bangle. So it gives me... raises EP, lowers strength and magic. 15 armor. Probably not worth it. Let's give her the power bangle for the time being, just so she does extra damage. Yeah, that seems like a good idea. Okay. And here's another one. Ugh, kid, you're getting on my nerves. Could you just do me a favor and buzz off? Oh, wait, I just thought of something. Yep, I think I'll let you live. And in return, I want you to go and take care of some pesky losers. Those nitwits think they can come up and start talking to me? Ha, the nerve. Sure. Okay, so I gotta repel the rejects. Right, I need you to track down that noisy ironclad Myrmidon and his friend, the hairy snout-nosed cavalier. Oh, and I forgot his name. But the last one in the trio is the worst. The worst! Get that shrimpy, potty-mouthed guy. Now, as proof, I'd like you to bring me their force. Sound good? Now off you go. Okay, so we just have to murder these people. These random people, I guess. Well, I heard you have to do some grinding anyway, so we might as well just run around smacking things for at least a little while. Okay, what are we up against? I really wish it would specifically show me... I wish it would show me my enemies instead of my characters when battle starts. Like, I think this is actually one of the only JRPGs I've ever seen that specifically goes out of its way to not show you the enemies you're going to be fighting before, like, while you're getting into the battle. Which is really weird, I think. Not entirely sure. God, the enemies are creepy, though. I actually really do like kind of the persona design that they've brought into this. Let's do that. Because he'll get the session. I think these guys are still weak to lightning? No, they're not weak to lightning. Oh, they're resistant to lightning. Yeah, so using overkill to actually boost the damage. Good plan. Gotcha. Okay. I do wish... you could turn off battle voices, though. Ugh, I don't know why they have that as a thing. Yeah, Atlas is very good at making disturbing enemies. Absolutely. I'm trying to think of, like, other JRPGs with particularly engaging enemy types. Final Fantasy has really good boss design. How am I liking the game so far? I think it's good. I was super grumpy about... What's this? Oh, gotta hit that from the other side. I was super grumpy about... Okay. Let's do the middle switch. I was super grumpy about, like, Digimon, for example, which they also made. I don't actually know if it's the same studio that made Digimon in retrospect. Somebody has a thing. Let's see. Itsuki's Carnage Ready for Unity Rapier. Well, we'll deal with that later. I think he's still leveling it up anyway. Wait, don't we already have a rapier? We do. What? Well, whatever. I'll think about that for later. Oh. Well, there's the, snout nose whatever. Okay. So, troll. This. So, resistant to swords, weak to axes, resistant to fire, weak to the rest of the elements. Okay, so not much I can do. Let's try using fire against the troll. Fire usually works against trolls. Yep. And there we go. But yeah, I actually really like, I really like this game. I think it's been designed particularly well. Okay, so... weak to lightning. Because Digimon had, like, a really good, you know, combination system, but I didn't feel like it was particularly inspired beyond that. Ow! Note to self, probably heal. Okay, we'll have enough time. Let's see, so... could just hit him. Let's go for this session. But, you know, I enjoy playing this one a lot more, so let's actually have her heal herself instead of just consistently just letting her die here. I actually don't know what... No. No, it's pretty easy to just revive characters. You just go to the vending machine and stuff. There's no vending machine inside of here, though. That sucks. Alright. We haven't tried lightning on him, but then again, we've got, Let's take out the Ironclad Cavalier and we'll take out the rest of the other guy. It's also really nice to have another game on my Wii U that actually is worth playing. Like, I really liked Xenoblade Chronicles X. And let's see, did we find out? Oh no, this guy's... we haven't figured out if this guy's weak to air. Let's check that. But like, Xenoblade Chronicles X was really good, and it was a good reason to turn on my Wii U. And now this game is, and I wish there were actually more third-party titles for the Wii U. Just because, like, this one's actually pretty this one's pretty satisfying to play. And it's kind of a shame that, you know, there aren't a whole lot more games like this. Okay, what's this? We've got Surefire. Oh, raises hit rate. And I think I did get... yeah, we're getting more Unity notes. I think I already got... her new weapon. Didn't I? Nope. Damn it! This game needs a town portal where I can just warp in and out. Constantly. So he's... oh no, rapier is a new one. Okay. We'll deal with that later. I don't feel like going back to town again, like right now. Okay, so nothing over there. Guess we gotta go around this way. I wanna just fight everything. I'm curious how long this dungeon is. I mean, it's a bit of a shame that it's starting to get repetitive, but hi, these guys are big. There's a lot of them, actually. Let's see. So we've got troll. Okay. Oh, interesting. You find out all their weaknesses after killing them. So weak to lightning, weak to fire, resistant to most melee. Weak to lightning, weak to spears. So if I select that one... I guess if we do this... no, nobody has any support skills. Okay, Dark Barbarian's not actually worth going after. If we do this, there we go. Okay, weak to swords, not fire, not fire. Not exactly the most effective things here, but yeah, I want to save my my special so I can use it against a boss. Or one of the gray enemies if I run into them. These guys are just basic trash mobs, so I don't really care too much. Oh, I'm almost done with this dungeon already. Well, that's good. Okay, so we got troll... Not weak. Oh. Never mind. Skewer. This guy's weak to spears. Death! I do wish I could turn off battle voices, though. Like, turn up music, turn down battle voices, because... Oof. I'm getting kind of sick of just hearing... all the time. Oh well, it doesn't matter too much. It's just one of those where it bothers me, to some degree, in JRPGs. Just hearing the characters say something constantly. Because this... I mean, for starters... I don't speak Japanese, so it doesn't even mean anything to me. But also from like a Let's Play perspective, it's pretty rough just trying to talk over people constantly. Okay, right. This guy's not weak to air. However, the alternative... Oh, wow! They've actually got like a damaged animation. It's really funny just watching him try and take his, try to like take his snout off the ground. Okay. Also, what's he got? Bane skills activate a session against specific classes, such as a dragon or horseback, regardless of affinities. For example, a horse slayer will always trigger a session as long as the enemy is a horseback mirage. Note that Bane skills also have a normal weapon affinity. So, this is a one... That is such a Fire Emblem thing, I love it. I've actually been getting a lot of hate comments on my first video because I was talking about the weapon triangle system being a Fire Emblem thing. And you know, everybody's angry because, you know, the weapon triangle is to... Ooh, a warp point. I guess we can't go back to the base. Well, we might as well do that. Okay. Let's grab the treasure first. But the weapon triangle in this game specifically is absolutely Fire Emblem. The elements are still Fire Emblem-y, but I'm pretty sure the way the triangle is set up, it's much more Persona-y. Or Shin Megami Tensei-y along the way. I don't know. It doesn't matter, but it's just like... It's kind of annoying when I get a bunch of comments from people calling me an idiot for saying that it's a Fire Emblem style X versus the other. Still can't get in this, right? Yeah. People are dumb. Alright, anyway, let's go outside. Let's go pick up our couple of weapons. I don't like doing this, but we might as well do it while we're here. But yeah, that's the other thing. Elemental, like, weapon weaknesses and type weaknesses have existed since for freaking ever. Topics from people. Okay, so we also have, Tsubasa has a Carnage ready for Unity, Radiant Lance, Steel Feather, Toma has Wind Spear, jeez. So many of these things. Tiki says, I think Tsubasa's song is wonderful, Mart was thumping really fast just for performing Unity, and Blue. Gotcha. I'm probably not going to read a whole lot. Yeah, I don't care about like 90% of this stuff. Okay, let's just buy some water and stuff. Okay, so the elemental ones are Shin Megami Tensei, physical are Fire Emblem. Yeah, I thought so. All right, let's go back to the Fortune office. Oh, you know what am I doing? Let's just warp. Duh. Better than walking. Oh, I can only teleport from inside a Dollosphere. Well, whatever. I guess we can just walk. I'm kind of surprised that they don't have just like a built-in, like actually fast travel. From that warp point, you'd think it would be a good idea to have, you know, the warp point allow you to warp back here and then back at any time. Oh, okay.
お兄ちゃん、こんにちは。こんにちは。いつき。こんにちは。二人は何を話してるんだ?シーダに翼お姉ちゃんと仲良くできてるか聞いてたんだ。お兄ちゃんはクロムと仲良くできてる?仲良しだよ。
俺と五木の関係は至って良好だ。うん、みんな仲良しでよかった。気にかけてくれてありがとう、チキ。そういえば、俺もクロムとシーダに聞きたいことがあるんだけど、いいかな?
何かしら?
クロムたちには俺たちの世界はどう見えてる？
どう見えているかか。単純な見え方という意味でならいつきと同じだ。
私たちはマスターの感覚を通してこの世界を見聞きしてるの。
感覚を通して。
ああ、いつきを通して見聞きした世界は興味深いものばかりだ。特にいつきたちがやっている歌や踊りといった芸能と呼ばれるものにはとても心が惹かれる。
ええ、翼が楽しそうに歌っていると私も楽しくなるわ。
そっか、二人とも前向きで少し気が楽になったよ。
心配してくれたのね、ありがとう。でも大丈夫、私たちの記憶を取り戻す手がかり全くないわけじゃないから。
ミラージュたちが起こしている事件、その謎を追うことが俺たち自身を知る手がかりになるはずなんだ。だからイツキ、俺たちはこれからもお前たちに手を貸すつもりだ。
ありがとう、二人とも。
私も頑張るからね、お兄ちゃん。
チキもよろしく頼むよ。
Well, that took a while. And now we have more texts from Tiki. Thank you, Tiki. Okay. Now she's texting me to tell me to go back to the Illusionary 106. I'm not an idiot. I'm here to go get new weapons from you. All right, got it. Yes, I'm aware. Carnage Unity, thank you. Oi. This takes a while. Okay, so, we already got Iron Sword, EP. We don't have Rapier, so let's go with that. Actually, hold on. Let's make sure we can make, Yeah, we can make both of these. Okay, cool. We can actually get, two weapons here. That's kind of useful. Yeah, it's weird how different the Mirages look from their original forms. Absolutely. I was actually really surprised about that. That with the Mirages in this game, like, Chrome and, Sheeta don't look at all like what they did in the games. Like, it's actually kind of weird, how much. Like, somebody was accusing me of noticing Sheeta's boobs got, like, much bigger between, you know, Fire Emblem Shadow Dragon in this game. But, like, the reality is, like, yeah, they did. And that's, I mean, the rest of her armor is just so different that it's like they're not the same character. It's just weird. Okay, let's grab the rapier. And then I think we're getting a lot of weapons here. I'm actually kind of surprised about it. I don't mind it. I just wish they had pulled some of the original designs in. Like, admittedly, Chrome's, like, strap thing going across his chest was kind of in the, in Awakening, but it was different. I don't know, it's hard to say, but yeah. Okay. So Tiki's young version has not changed. Okay. Yeah, I have no idea. It's been a long time since I've seen Tiki in anything anyway. Okay, and no. I also do like how happy-go-lucky this game is. It's very just, I'm not gonna say relaxing, but still. Okay, I don't think I have any Radiant Unities that I can make. Yep, doesn't look like it. Alright, that's fine. Now let's get out of here. Let's go fight. But yeah, I don't know, I think it would have been cooler if they'd actually truly pulled in more of the character designs. I guess, in retrospect, Kane kind of looks like what Kane looked like. Kane's design hasn't changed as much. The helmet is new, though, I think. I don't think he had, like, the crazy over-large helmet along the way. Let's see if we figured out why the Mirages don't remember anything. Nope! No, there's been, like, next to no development in terms of, the Mirages, but that's okay. Okay. I keep expecting people to start talking to me, so I'm kind of in a quiet mood. But then again, I've been kind of in a quiet... I've been feeling quiet today, anyway. It's been a long week. I've been walking a lot lately, actually, which has been really nice, because it's finally warm out. Problem is, there's gnats freaking everywhere, because it's warm, so they're like, sweet, and, I'm very edible. So I have, like, several gnat bites. It's not nearly as bad as, like, mosquito bites. I hate mosquito bites so much. Okay. But, at the same time, I've just got, like, bites all over my calves and stuff, and I'm just like, I love walking. I don't love this, though. Okay, if I skewer this guy, yep, he just gets ruined. Let's go with that. Getting up to the 7th floor is a bit of a puzzle. Alright. Pretty as much. I do kind of wish instead of jumping, the troll would, like, kind of totter over on his teeny little legs. He doesn't do that. He doesn't really need to do that. It'd just be really funny. Okay. Can we do anything to that guy? Not really. I guess we might as well just go for the Axeman then. I don't like bug bites. They don't bother me too much. My family is from Minnesota. Minnesota has really bad mosquito problems because it's got like just a ton of lakes all over the place, so it's pretty much always a great breeding ground for, let's see, resistant to swords, weak to lightning. It's a great breeding ground for mosquitoes, so every time we'd visit, I'd get a bunch of deer fly and mosquito bites. Those itch. So now it's not so bad. But it's definitely one of those where, like, I'm looking forward to not having to deal with these as summer progresses, because it's been hella dry around here. It's been hella dry around here, so there's, like, no mosquitoes, it's just gnats. And that actually helps, like, a ton. Fire Slash. Is that a... That's a session skill. Okay, cool. So we can chain that with, what's-his-face. Toma, there we go. Upgrade on Skewer. I like the weapon system in this game. Feels good. I'm actually really looking forward to seeing just how many weapons and weapon skills there are in this game. Okay. Oh gosh, you're the human I met earlier. Some other human with a really scary looking face went through here earlier. Over there, mister. That human went that way. It's scary. Okay. Is this the way it came up? I don't think so. Surprise sword! Ah! Alternatively, surprise sword, not surprise sword. Let's try fighting the savage enemy. I should probably save after this. Alright, so what are we up against? Whole slew of enemies. How much SP do I have? I got an amount. Okay. So we got Ironclad Cavaliers, weak to... Ooh, that's a bit rougher. Luckily, we've got the Dark Barbarians that I can just sword hit kill with empty wave. That's gonna suck. We don't have any axe characters. I wonder if I can run from battle. Haven't checked that, actually. I also haven't failed a battle yet. I have no idea what losing does. I assume it sends you back to your reload point. Oh, this is gonna hurt. Okay. And there it goes. Okay! Fuck. Whee! Well. Whoopsie. Actually, can I use a skill if a person's downed? I can't. Well, that sucks. Alright! I could use the revival bread. That shit's expensive, though. Where's the trapport stone? There we go. Yes. I think we will do this. Ow! I was really hoping everybody would revive back to 1 HP like a lot of JRPGs do now. Not That's not how it works. Anyway, let's drink some water, which will recover everybody. This is cheaper. See, does that count as failing? No. No, it does not. Could have been... That could have been way, way worse. At least... I thought I'd maybe have a chance, but those guys specifically use the weapon triangle against me. Because I don't have any axe users. I have two lance users, so if I'm up against... If I'm up against an axe user in any way, shape, or form... Or not axe user, a lance... Yeah, axe users will wreck my shit. I can technically do damage to them, but still. I don't know. Pain. Okay, whatever. Let's save before we go back up. Okay. Now people are texting me again. See, I get a lot of, like, random texts from the various characters here. But, 90% of it is meaningless and generally related to a text message. Okay, let's get... There we go. This is why we don't fight foes. Yeah, probably a good idea. Oh, is he saying bread is a joke, or does he not know it's bead? Oh, is it? See, there's soft drink, lifestone, okay. Bead. Yeah, I thought it was just bread. It's like, alright, let's just eat some bread. I mean, like, half of this shit is food. Look, we've got Revival Bead, which does the same thing as Fresh Spicy Curry. I would not be surprised if it wasn't named Revival Bread for all everything's it's set up in this game. I don't know. But whoops, whatever. Hi, this is a lot of guys. Okay. Let's see. Nobody's mounted. Oh shit, those guys on the wheels are mounted. I didn't even think about that. Okay, well, let's work on this one. Yeah, I will keep that in mind for, I will keep that in mind in the future. I wonder if you could get, I wonder if you could get a 3-combo session or more. I'd have to think about that. But yeah, no, I don't like the, the totally arbitrary, I don't like the totally arbitrary text messages that I get from the characters. Like, it's supposed to make them feel like they have personality and stuff, but it just ends up feeling kind of weird. I'd rather them put effort into making, like, moments where the characters just decide to talk to each other or something, I don't know. Okay, are you weak to wind? You are. You're not. Okay, we might as well go for this session here. You can get more than 3 hits in the session. Okay, I'd have to look into how that works. Okay, is it just this guy? Oh, he's weak to lightning, right? And yeah, it's just this guy. Perfect. Oh, you need more party members, though. So you mean to tell me that you can have more than 3 people in a party here? Oh, I had just assumed this game capped you out at 3 people. Never mind, then. Well, that's cool. I always just operate under the assumption that 3 is the maximum. Guess not. Alright, let's stay away from the foes. Stay away from the U. Hello. Let's get this open at the very least. Okay, so this gives me some options. So... Go left switch first. Okay, let's take this around. I want to go look for loot and stuff first. Oh, that's funny. I got a thing called Illusory Bully. That's amazing. Okay, you can have 3, but the other's concession link. Oh, well that's useful. Okay. So there's a bead chain, or as I'd like to call it, a bread chain. No. Nope, well, never mind. I was just gonna beat everybody up, but... Ooh, hey, now we got somebody I can use Horse Slayer on. Because this guy counts as mounted, you can tell. Because there's a horse attached to it. That's cool. So the other guys must count as like some other different enemy type here. It'd be an interesting thing to look into. Okay. So question is, we do get a session off of Horse Slayer. Perfect. Well, that did not work out for it. That's a lot of damage. I like it. But yes, Bread Shane. Which, isn't that, Hala? Hala? I want to say it's like a Jewish type of bread. But that's like terrible cultural insensitivity. I just remember really, really having some good, like, Hala or Chala or however you freaking pronounce it. I don't know, man. Back in California. And then the bakery, like, just totally stopped being good. I was like, no, no, don't do this to me. Made me sad. Bane weapons hurt in Fire Emblem. Good to know. I should probably actually fight some of these things, but still. Yeah. Oh, shit. It's only the mid-tier? Never mind that. There's our answer. Okay. Now we gotta go get back. Oh, we gotta get back down. But we've actually got a barrier. Let's fight this guy. Cause we do wanna train a little bit here. Hi! You're big. All of you are big. What are you weak to? Not much. Okay, let's go for the troll. I'm just like not used to several trolls being available in any given fight. Shame that their resistances count for sessions, but it makes sense. I wonder if I can switch that around. Probably not. Anyway, jellyfish weak to sword. I'm looking forward to this game getting even deeper. I've actually been I know on the website it lists every single playable character, but I've actually like totally just avoided that one. Let's see if I can kill this guy. Yep, there it goes. That does a fair amount of damage, actually. Nice. Weak to lightning. Okay. If I'm understanding it right, it's pronounced Hala with a generous helping of Thrifty Phlegm at the beginning. Oh shit, that was Empty Wave. Why did I do Empty Wave? I thought I did Cleave. Alright, well, whatever. I guess we just beat the shit out of that troll that didn't die? Oh, also, apparently when trolls are downed, they actually gain a weakness to physical. Interesting. But yeah, I've been avoiding looking at who any of the characters are for this game, even though I know it says on both the wiki and the website. It's just like, I don't really feel like finding out too much here. Okay, so we gotta get back to... Gotta get back to this one, there we go. Huh. Should probably get that loot, come to think of it. Whatever, we'll get it later. I guess actually it would be really easy to get, too. I just have it shrug. We'll do that after we fight the boss. I don't really feel like sticking around too long. Though I might have to. We'll save before we go back up there and stuff. Okay. Thought trolls always had a weakness to swords and spears. Nope! So when you down a troll, it gains a weakness to lances and axes. Which is interesting. Yeah, I accidentally did Dia. Alright, whatever. Let's see. Because right now he's got a resistance to swords and spears. Okay, so there's the Myrmidon. Let's go for the Dark Barbarian. Should be able to kill him with his session. And then there's the other guy. Okay. So now we want to do... We don't have anybody mounted. Right. We want to do... Myrmidon, because he'll go down faster. Okay. Curious what happened to Sword City. Time happened to Sword City. This game came out, and I'm going to be totally honest, I really enjoy this game more than, say, Sword City, for example. It's like, I don't know, there's so many games for me to cover on a given day that I can only cover so many. And like, I put out 8 videos today? I think I put out 8 videos today. That's a lot. And just like, even like an extra half hour episode of anything becomes almost unmanageable. And like the obvious thing would be to like stagger it and do like every other. But even then, I can't do that. I have no time for anything. Once Shell gets here, it'll be a little bit easier. I really wanted to play this game with Shell, actually, but she doesn't get here until a week from, or next Friday. So it's Surefire? Oh, more hit rate. We haven't really run into accuracy issues yet. Oh, whatever. Okay. Let's go fight this boss. We should probably save before I go into a... go into the chamber, though? Well... maybe not, actually. No, they totally said the boss went up this direction. Hopefully there's a Healy thing before we actually fight the boss. Boop. Okay, it's not a foe. We might as well keep fighting these guys, because I need a lot of stuff here. Okay, so we want to do... hi! I really like just throwing the double troll at me. I love the design for the troll, though. Like, from the weird purple burning thing in the middle of, from the weird purple burning thing to... Manowar? Manowar is weak to... that. No, we'll kill the Manowar on his next turn. There's really nothing she can do to them. Alright, whatever. Okay. Leave on the jellyfish, and then we're good past this. Oh, there is a warp, though. Good to know. So I'll just go get a drink. Okay, so we want to do... I guess we might as well do Fire Strike. That should get the overkill. And then we'll focus fire the other guy. Is that how it works? Kind of? I don't know, I'd have to look into the direct mechanics for overkill in this game. Oh, well. It's for a different day. All right, now I'm lazy. Okay, I want to check something. A lot of enemies have a dark flame design in their model. That's cool. So I want to check. Oh, no! He didn't gain that, the weakness overall. I wonder what that was. Maybe it was the special move that gave the guy the weakness. No? I have no idea. All right, it doesn't really matter. I just remember a troll had a weakness to, had a random weakness. Oh, she's got Dancer's Aura. Alright, we get to turn that into something. Okay, Wind... what? Oh! It's support session for Wind and Thunder moves. Gotcha. I see how that works. So, there's two elements per session reaction thing along the way. Okay. I actually don't know my way around this. Kind of a maze. Question is, do the enemies disappear when I get the loot? I think they do, actually. Now let's hope we don't run into a foe. Out of my way. Yeah, we'll just keep fighting things. I know it's, I know it's kind of boring to fight the same enemies over and over and over and over and over and over again, but at the same time, this is a Persona Shin Megami Tensei like. We just murdered a lot of things, didn't we? Well, that's several jellyfishes down, and there's a cavalier down. Oh, that's a level 14 cavalier too. Whoa, nice. But yeah, because it's a SMT type game, it's going to get kind of mean, and I kind of want to be ready for that instead of just like, you know, being really low level and getting my ass kicked. But I don't want to, like, go wildly out of my way for grinding, obviously. Because that gets really boring, but still. So what I'm going to do is just fight more or less every single enemy in my way. And go from there. And I think she just got a new skill. What the hell is this? Oh, cures poison. Pasu Moody. What kind of name is that? Unfortunately, after a certain point, we're going to have to get rid of skills. Hopefully, we can switch them in and out on the fly as needed. It would be really, really annoying if this did the Pokemon thing where it's like, by the way, You can't use this item ever. You can't use this skill ever again. We'll figure it out. Okay. I'm sad. I always want to buy more mounted enemies. Horse Slayer is just so satisfying to hit people with. Then again, never mind. That worked out too. Okay. So let's do cleave. Let's do cleave on this guy. We should probably kill him. Nope. Hey, got him. All right. I also just really enjoyed the combat in this game. It's much better than I expected it would be. After Digimon, I was like, not super interested in the idea of, you know, SMT games. And now we're here and I'm like, ooh, this means Persona 5 is probably going to be really fun. Probably not, though. Okay. So let's see. Yeah, nothing. I'm glad it grays out skills that I can't use. It's nice. Okay. I really hope at some point Itsuki goes from like an everyman to a something else. It'd be really weird if he just stays everyman for the entire game. Well, maybe not weird, but I feel like it would be a little weird if he stayed, let's see. It'd be really weird if he stayed everyman the entire time. Either that or, I mean, he could be a beveryman. You never know. I should have hit it, shouldn't have I? Prefer more involved combat. I guess the reason why I'm okay with, the reason why I'm okay with, this game's combat is because this is what I feel like, you know, if you're gonna have turn-based combat, this is what you should have. Like, I'm specifically thinking of, like, Pokemon, for example. Pokemon has, like, at this point, in my opinion, some of the most boring turn-based, like, you know, JRPG-style combat. And it's kind of sad, because I really like Pokemon. I guess let's just turn on auto battle, we'll probably beat it to death. There we go. Okay, talking about how they changed their titles is spoilers. Ah, okay, well, they still changed their titles. That's all I need to know. Okay, yep, this is gonna be it. So let's go get a drink. Okay. Because, like, I love Pokemon, but I feel like the combat's become really stale. Whereas this game actually has, like, a really fun combat system. The sessions and the use of the type weaknesses don't... Like, hitting an enemy with their type weakness doesn't, like, just insta-give them half the time. It kind of does, a little bit. But, like, in Pokemon, I always hate just having, like, a grass type that I like using and somebody just randomly has a fire type move and just kills my guy, and I'm just like, oh. Alright, well, I guess that's it. Let's go back. I think I can make at least two things, right? Yeah, we got two. We might as well just grab everything along the way. Let's see. Personally gotten sick of Tales of Combat games. I think that's because, like, Tales Combat peaked in Symphonia and has never really improved particularly well. I don't know. Hard to say. Okay. Didn't know if she had anything particularly useful. Okay, so what's EP Fitness do? It was her, right? Yes, there we are. Oh, max EP by 10%. Not actually that useful, but still. Press X. Oh, press X when I'm in Shibuya to go to the world map faster. You're right. I totally forgot you could just instantly go to the map there. Okay, so I don't have any other weapons along the way either. Let me think. No, I like the combat in this game. I like the combat in Tales of games, though I will agree they've gotten a little stale. Zestiria did not capture me in nearly the same way that Symphonia ever did. I think that's because Symphonia was, like, much more side-scrolly, whereas Zestiria tried to be, like, 3D, and it didn't work out as well. I'm trying to think of other games with, like, interesting combat systems. I mentioned earlier, X-2. Final Fantasy X-2 had a really good combat system for, like, a JRPG, where, yeah, your characters would just automatically fight for you, but you'd pick, you know, their special moves and stuff. I felt like that was a good, I thought that was a good system.